In this video, we're going to talk about a hidden gem known as Yop. Now, Yop, let me just state right now, is a project that I believe has incredible growth potential as we near DeFi summer. So with that being said, let's dive into Yop and I'll tell you what it's all about and why the potential here is incredible. Now, the first thing that I'm going to let you know that I want to state is obviously I'm not a financial advisor, so do your own research and invest at your own risk, okay? Now, the other thing that I want to tell you is essentially, I have a very big quarrel with projects that try to become jack of all trades. And I want to state that in the very beginning before I dive into why I think Yop is actually a good project, but its Achilles heel, if you will, or the potential downfall, is you'll notice that a lot of projects and new organizations, whatever it is, right? They go ahead and they focus on one area, what they're trying to accomplish. So Yop is a little interesting to me, and I do believe it has so much growth potential, and I'll talk about the team behind it as well. But the reason why I think the Achilles heel to Yop is being the jack of all trades is because of all of the products and solutions that they have. So we're going to go over Yop, but you'll also see why I'm very bullish at the current price that it's at and how it's going to just tremendously see incredible growth because it makes it easier for the average retail investor to get involved in the DeFi space. So Yop is a yield optimization platform and protocol, your all-in-one yield optimization application. So it's cross-chain, Yop powered by Ethereum, Binance Smart Chain, Polkadot, Solana ecosystem, and it's fueled by the Yop token. Now, let's actually run down the different products that they have and what they actually do. Now, I want to make it very clear that it's not necessarily a bad thing when they offer all of this. However, a lot of times, if we just take a look at projects like PancakeSwap, they have their exchange. It's essentially an exchange, but there's liquidity that's being provided as well. And the exchange won't work without the liquidity. But it's not like PancakeSwap went out there and solely focused on building the liquidity before they went ahead and built the exchange. It was kind of hand in hand. And then they built out the lottery system and everything else that they kind of built out once they had a solidified product and a lot of users. Now, the only thing that I see with Yop that I don't necessarily, not that I don't like it, because I'm in no place to judge, because I've personally never built a project to this extent, but what I will say is it's very hard to nail down all these products in one when you don't necessarily have a massive hit yet. However, just bear with me here. So Yop is downloadable on your phone. So we have the Y platform, the yield optimization platform, all-in-one yield optimization platform that makes it easy for everyone to access yield markets, giving you control, custody, insights, and flexibility directly in one application. Every token, every pool. That's insane. That is incredible, especially for anybody who has a smartphone and having the ability to access all of that on your smartphone. Now, why this is important is because it's easy to access by anybody. And by the way, I downloaded it on my phone as well. I went through it. I thoroughly enjoyed the user interface and the experience as well. So kudos to Yop for that. Then we have the yield optimization protocol. The protocol is our proprietary mechanism to allow everyone simplified access to yield markets, providing dynamic portfolio management with automated impermanent loss protection, aggregation, and reward protocols. Every blockchain, every reward. So again, going ahead and providing liquidity essentially, because again, you can have impermanent loss, and I'm not going to go too deep into impermanent loss when you provide liquidity. But again, if they have dynamic portfolio management with automatic impermanent loss protection, that's huge, because a lot of new investors in the DeFi space have no idea what impermanent loss means when they're providing liquidity to, let's just say, a brand new project, a brand new token. It's something that I'm not going to go too deep into, but it's a very big problem for those that don't understand what impermanent loss actually means and does. So they go over the problem that they go ahead and they overcome. Then the apps, okay? So the app, you have basically farms, all right? You have a DEX, so where you can exchange tokens. And farms is essentially, if you went to PancakeSwap, you clicked on farms, you went to Uniswap. Well, that's technically completely different. But you have PancakeSwap farms, you have Pancake Bunny, that's a farm. There's so many different farms, my goodness. There's Beefy as a farm. So again, farms is essentially where you go ahead and you provide assets, you provide your assets in terms of liquidity, and you create liquidity contracts, and you get rewards, and those rewards are based on, well, a lot of things. Typically, an oracle determines those rewards. Well, not typically, an oracle determines those rewards, and that's where the APY comes from. You get the daily and obviously the APY, the annual percentage yield. So for transparency purposes, I haven't really dove deep into their farmer market and how the algorithm is actually set into that particular marketplace that they have, but it is nicely laid out and very easy for a beginner to get started. So obviously we have a swap DEX. It's a decentralized exchange where you can go ahead and swap tokens. Then we have MyYop, which kind of shows your growth. You have the Yop wallet, so obviously just like a normal wallet. Then we have market data, again, shows you market data. So there's a lot happening. Like I said, it's kind of like a jack of all trades here, where they have a lot of different moving parts in here that's happening in one. Can it confuse new people? Sure. But somebody like myself, and probably like you, who's a little bit more seasoned, you probably understand what's going on in here with the farms, with the DEX, and what you're looking at, and how to judge the charting and all of that inside their application, so it makes more sense. So let's actually move on and talk about their Launchpad aggregator. Again, this is what I'm trying to enforce to you. There's so much happening. They have their app. We have a Launchpad aggregator. It's a yield optimization pad. Yop will allow customers to access a wide host of decentralized launch protocols. Our Launchpad aggregator will access IDO smart contracts and allow customers to directly participate from the Yop platform. So let me just keep reading. There will also be access for Yop holders to Yop exclusive pools, giving early access to incubated projects and portions of some aggregated pools. Now, I haven't personally used the Launchpad, but typically what happens with Launchpad projects is they see incredible growth. Launchpad projects are massive, they're huge, they're incredible. And what essentially a Launchpad does is just that. It launches a brand new project in their ecosystem, and it essentially gathers investors to launch that particular token. It just gathers a lot of money for that particular project and launches it. That's in so many words. It's like launching a brand new project, a brand new coin, gathering liquidity for it, et cetera. So again, there's a lot more that goes into an IDO and a launch pad than just that. But there's other launch pads like TrustSwap that are just absolutely incredible. The ROIs are insane. However, just like TrustSwap, I assume that Yop, you have to stake a certain amount of Yop to go ahead and have allocation into a specific Launchpad launch. So I don't think if you just have one Yop, you're automatically allocated and allowed in to go ahead and be able to participate in a launch. So with that being said, they have a Launchpad. Launchpads are great, not necessarily like the main product I would focus on here, only because a lot of Launchpad projects, they require KYC in the United States, which means that you'd have to submit your information, and once they see you're in the US, you're not allowed to participate in Launchpad releases. So if you try it on like TrustSwap, for example, you can't participate if you're in the US because of regulations. So that's why I didn't look too deep into the Yop Launchpad, because traditionally launch pads and being involved in those type of launches require KYC. And if you're from the US, which I am, more than likely you're not allowed to participate in the actual launch pad. But I could be wrong. Again, like I said, do a little bit more research, because I went ahead, saw the launch pad, but I was interested in their entire ecosystem overall, and there was a lot to digest. Now, we see they went ahead and launched their competition. They kind of talked about it. So now we have the Y platform, as they call it, and the Y protocol. Now, let me dive a little bit deeper into these without really boring you. And I'm going to go ahead and just cover these. Basically, the Y platform does a lot of things at one time. So it connects you to the farm, farmers market, to different farms. Live aggregation, pricing, and community engagement. Use one seamless application so you can optimize farming and staking. So it shows you all the different farming pools that you have the ability to access and everything else. Benefit from the best market rates and most liquidity, so you get all that information directly delivered to you. The best data available for better performance. What really frustrates me about this is that the product is a great product, okay? This is great for retail investors. However, if you were to use something like Yearn, Yearn, the whole purpose of it is to automate this. And I'm not dissing and saying Yop is garbage. As a matter of fact, I'm saying it's a hidden gem. This is a great project. But what I'm also saying is that they aggregate all this information for you, yet you still have to make that decision on your behalf. If they were able to go ahead and make the decision for you on your behalf, they have the potential to grow astronomically, because then they can dynamically make sure that your money, the APY that you earn in these farms, is dynamic at all given times. So they put you in the best pools that earn the highest rewards without you having to constantly search on your phone or search through the marketplace to see which one and move your money around manually. So swap, farm, harvest, store with a complete set of tools, etc. So you get the idea. This is the Y platform, essentially providing you all the most recent up-to-date analytical data for different farms. Then we have the Y protocol. Now Yop is building a leading protocol that builds on the successful decentralized finance protocols. By implementing custom features set in their smart contracts, we provide more value to the users on our platform and to the Yop token in the network. And again, this will just go ahead and kind of show you the outline of how Yop performs and exactly everything that is going on behind the scenes. Then we have the owner of Yop, network integration, we have their roadmap, all of this. But now let's keep moving down the line. So Atif over here is the founder of Yop, and Atif has an extensive background. And I think he was actually a financial advisor. I think he worked for a financial advisory firm, if I'm correct. I could be wrong. I know he has something or ties in the financial world, which was something that I saw when I was watching an interview, I think it was, in Sheldon Evans' Patreon, or when I was watching an interview elsewhere. I completely forgot where I saw an interview, but I remember he has ties to be able to raise capital very easily. And so he's public, so he's doxed. The entire team is doxed as well. And if you take a look at some of the accolades of the team, it's actually fairly impressive. So I do trust this project alone based off of the fact of the team. And at the end of the day, like I always tell you guys, we're not investing essentially into a project. Yes, the use case and what it does is super important, but at the end of the day, it doesn't matter how good the project is if the team behind it is absolute garbage and doesn't know what to do or have the resources or the manpower or the capability to market it and get it to market efficiently, really well, and have the ability to actually get more capital if needed, then the project's gonna go nowhere. And we've seen a lot of projects that have great potential that die off because of those aspects. So when it comes down to it, you gotta make sure that a team is rock solid, and Yop team is just that. They are rock solid. So this is interesting. Yop approached the launch in a very unique way compared to other tokens. And we're talking about kind of Yop launching their particular token. And our token economics, or as we call them, Yoponomics, are designed for the most fair distribution to avoid large holders punishing new participants. For this reason, we focus on a wider distribution during the seed and private round, and more importantly, kept the price flat. So again, if we take a look at their tokenomics, and I dove deeper into their tokenomics paper, we can just see right over here how it's all split up. Now, this is important that you understand right here. The team tokens are vested over 2 years, and we'll get to that in just a second. But you can see the seed and pre-sale is 12%, early backers, long-term holders. And then we have the liquidity reserve, future token sales. Then we have the team, which is 10%. We have marketing, which is 15%, but token release over 1K, and then 6 months vesting applies. Now, we have to take a look at the vesting schedule and see what it's like. Because at the end of the day, a project like this, if you see that all the tokens are released upon token generation event, TGE, that isn't very comforting. That means that all the tokens would be released to the team for marketing, for development, for public sale, for everything. Everything would be released and there's no vesting. So they provided a vesting schedule, and you see exactly how many tokens get released during what time period, and you can see that it goes all the way to Q4 of 2023 when the final vesting period actually ends, and the circulating supply will be 88,888,000, etc. You get the idea. So they have vesting nailed down, and their vesting schedule is really, really good. Now, one of the last things I want to talk about is Yop Vault, redefining single asset staking. Now, let's read this together. As we continue to make waves in DeFi with a novel approach to launch, today we outline details of the Yop Vault. So you might be thinking many projects offer single asset staking, Yop launching a single asset vault as well. What's different? Two big things. They are committing the entire reward amount, 100% of it, to the people that are staking. So often projects announce large APY reward plans, but if they are not taken up within a set date, the balance goes back to the project. Today, we're committing 1 million YOP tokens to the YOP Vault smart contract forever. That means no matter what the take up is, these tokens will not come back to the project, and effective burn if not claimed. So they got burned if those tokens weren't claimed, if there weren't enough people to go ahead and, you know, stake and receive those rewards, the following million YOP got burned. So the second difference is that there is no fixed end date to the contract. The YOP vault is governed by participation. It's governed by participation. Keep that in mind. So it doesn't close down. It essentially just keeps on going, for anybody who wants to participate. Until every YOP token in the contract is claimed, it will remain open, like I just said. And as we're committing the 1 million YOP tokens forever with no option to claim them back whatsoever. So they effectively burn their own tokens and gave them back to the public or people that are staking YOP. So they're rewarding people for going ahead and locking up their YOP and giving back a million YOP of their own, essentially. So the other thing that I want to address before I end this is the way that they can actually get capital, retain capital, and build capital is a lot easier than other projects, which again is why I'm extremely bullish and why the team, and led by Atif, is something that I personally like, because of the fact that they have the ability to easily get capital if needed. But again, as stated, and it was a private video that I watched, as stated, they're not necessarily looking for capital because of the simple fact that they can do it very bootstrapped. They have raised a little bit as far as I'm aware, but it's not like incredible amounts. And so right up here, you can see YOP secures London Stock Exchange listed investor and partner. So they've secured partners, and they announced right over here that YOP has agreed funding from traditional venture funds that is listed on the London Stock Exchange. They have Pyres Investment PLC. And Pyres took YOP through a rigorous due diligence and technical review process, which lasted 7 weeks. All right, so this is absolutely incredible. And then we have other firms as well that went and kind of chimed in. But the most important one here is Pyres Investment PLC. Now, again, like I said, this is extremely important that you understand that they have the ability to access capital as needed whenever they essentially need it because of somebody who's running it, Atif, because of somebody like Atif running this project. It makes me very confident that this can go somewhere. So we discussed everything about YOP and why this is a hidden gem. And like I said, the overarching image that you want to go ahead and see, or the vision that you want to see, is that YOP is going to open up the decentralized finance world to a lot of investors, retail investors that want to get into DeFi but aren't sure where to start and don't know where to look. YOP is as easy as grabbing your phone, going ahead and downloading the YOP app, and get started right away, start farming, and a lot of other things that you can do in the YOP app also. So it makes the ease of use extremely, extremely easy for anybody to use, right? So that's why I'm extremely bullish on YOP and why I think it's a hidden gem. If you also know about any hidden gems, leave it in the comments down below. My name is Dan from the Hidden Gem Network. It's been a pleasure yet again to provide you with another gem, and I'll catch you soon.